Been part of this setup since 2014. He is a stalwart of Argentina sevens, and he's a big reason, Rob Bickerman, while this outfit have put themselves in touch of a series title.
Absolutely, he's one of these warriors that's so dependable. You mentioned 50 tournaments. This is the most experienced team in the tournament. Argentina playing against a team that have really been struggling at times. The Japanese are always going to be committed. They always have that will to want to have a go, but their skill set just letting them down a bit. And it might well be a tough position against this Argentina team, who are flying high.
And congratulations to Nika and Marshall Kelly from Georgia, who will referee his first game on the series. The shrill sound of his whistle, and it'll be Gaston Ravol, the 35-year-old, playing in his 87th event all time. For Schultz, there he is, the 50-capper, wins possession for Argentina right at the start of this one. Felipe Del Mestre bursting through straight away for Argentina, and they are going to have a try inside 15 seconds here against Japan.
And it's not surprising that we see the score from the restart. One of their areas of domination of late is getting that ball back from the restart. Del Mestre takes that ball to the line, but it's the skill set, the necessary components of an effective restart, a good kick, a good response to it, and then they're straight in. Pistons flying already. 36% restarts retained in Vancouver, and it seems as though they're on a similar path out here in Toulouse.
Del Mestre, part of the bronze medal winning team of Argentina at the Tokyo Olympic Games. Conversion from Tobias Wade, curls it round, but just on the outside of the sticks. But it's a fine start to this one from Argentina. Ravolgo slightly longer this time, jumping all by himself. Shotaro Suoka for Japan, and then going in for the steal was Santiago Vierafeld. And here come Argentina. Schultz over the top. That's a bit too heavy for Joaquin de la Vega.
It's that ability to just change the pace of their attack and make Argentina so dangerous. We're seeing this ball in hand, but they're one of the best teams at kicking the ball as well. Plenty of options for them right across the pitch. And we haven't even yet mentioned one of the stars of the game, who currently is sitting on an icebox on the sideline. Marcus Moneta, when he gets it, when he comes on, just enjoy it.
Yeah, World Rugby Player of the Year waiting in the wings, Marcos Moneta. No doubt his energy being saved for matches to come at this tournament. In Japan, well, they are in a whole heap of trouble on the standings. Heavy relegation candidates. As things stand, they got the penalty here, though. They picked up just 3 standings points from Singapore and Vancouver. And if you want to keep coronation status, you need a better return than that. Former England Sevens and Team GB head coach Simon Amor, a consultant, high performance consultant for Japan Sevens, trying to get them up the standings and develop players coming through.
Yeah, he's on a really big learning curve with that as well, trying to take in everything culturally what this Japanese team can offer. Very different to either a GB or England program that Simon's used to, so it's exciting to see what his thoughts will be and how he can shape this team going forward.
Real to Kano. That's a nice inside ball from Kano to Fukushi. He stands in the tackle. Here's Latinara Soejima, sets up the breakdown. Brilliant documentary piece with Soejima on the World Rugby website during the rounds. Catch that if you can, and catch him if you can. Taiga Ishida will hit back for Japan. Good pace down the sideline. Ravol couldn't catch him.
You mentioned about what the Japanese team can do with ball in hand, and it is find these big, powerful runners. They tended to find that the successful teams of years gone by were big and physical, so they completely adapted programs to be exactly that. And when you see the size of these players in full flight, you can see how threatening they can be with ball in hand. So it's a really good effort from the Japanese team.
Conversion from out wide doesn't make it, so remains 5 each, but really, really important hit back for the Brave Blossom Sevens. 3 to go in this first half. This would be a massive result if Japan could beat Argentina, one of the top seeds here at the France Sevens. That's been flicked back, but Del Mestre's onto it for Argentina. He flicks it up to De La Vega, a lovely little inside curve, offloads the ball. Tobias Wade, but it's numbers on the far side. Gonzalez juggles it. Luciano Gonzalez finishes for Argentina. Straight away, they're back in front.
Well, I'm so glad he caught that. I would not want to see this man cross. There's a ball at the best of times. Lovely footwork from Argentina, talking about how good they are. Ball on toe, and then the balance and understanding. The hidden factor, well, it's not that hidden, but the thing that Argentina do better than most is support. And within seconds, within a second, they get to the breakdown, retain the ball, and as you mentioned, threats right across the field. And this guy's about as threatening as you get.
5'9", 95 kilograms. That's heavy.
He's thick, isn't he? He's an absolute specimen. Lovely to see Gonzalez play for this team and just the passion that he possesses.
It's his 81st try all time for Argentina on the series. Luciano Gonzalez picked up his 50th in Paris back in 2019. Herman Schultz again wins it for Argentina, the 50 capper. Brilliant at the restarts. Del Mestre. Revol, here is Luciano Gonzalez. Bounces off one, then gets the handoff going. Look at him go, he's a bulldozer. But he gets stripped. That was good work from Moeki Fukushi. And can Japan hit back like they did after conceding their opening try? Here's Latianara Soejima. Nice little offload back to him. Stands in the tackle. Sets up a breakdown just outside his 22. Still a minute to go in this first half. It's hot here.
Brock.
33, 34 degrees Celsius in the southwest of France. Players working hard. The captain, Nakagawa. Oh, sneak from down. Ishida.
Backwards.
So Ojima just can't quite hold on to it. Goes over the sideline. So that'll be a line out for Argentina. Yeah, brilliant piece. If you catch it on the World Rugby Digitals, we're not allowed to mention his age anymore, but I can tell you he's not far off 40. Oh, there it is. He said in the piece, people are going to stop talking about my age.
No, he said me. I like to cling on the fact that players are still older than me. So, no, absolutely brilliant piece, wasn't it? And the emotion, his backstory, the problems he's faced, his resilience, and his passion for the game is brilliant.
Revol on the wraparound. Here's Gonzalez. Dummy. They're trying to strip the ball again, Japan. It's a clear tactic from them in the tackle. They don't get it clear on that occasion. Herman Schultz. Clock's in the red. Final play of the first half. Revol. Wade, and here's De La Vega. Good cover defense coming in from Suoka. De La Vega almost there. Gonzalez arrives. Picks and goes and scores for Argentina.
And that was really intelligent officiating in this bottom corner. Look at him. Scary to meet down the street, wasn't he? But it was good to play again, getting that ball wide. And fair play. Soccer got back to try and stop it. But because De La Vega pushed the ball back at him, they were given the benefit of the doubt. That ball is then free. And a sniff for Gonzalez ended him over the line.
Two tries in the first half to Gonzalez. Wade doesn't get the extra two. So 17-5, Argentina lead Japan at halftime. Santiago Gomez Corda. Here he is in that light blue polo shirt. Absolute legend of rugby sevens. What a career that guy had. 61 events, 230 tries, 1,178 points, the king of the chip and chase, Santi Gomez-Cora. Played against him many times, Vicks, no doubt.
Yeah, fair few. Chipped me a fair few as well. And he's passing on his skill set to these wonderful players, certainly. He is the sensei to Monata. No one better to learn from and how to use the ball on the floor.
And was thrilled after Vancouver. Absolutely thrilled, breaking a 13-year drought for an event title.
Yeah, they beat us in the final. But it was amazing then, just seeing how much it meant to them.
Argentina leading Japan 17-5 at half-time. This is Pool A. On day one here at the France 7th in Toulouse. And coming up, the hosts, this place will increase the volume for that. And then it's Fiji, double Olympic champions, up against Kenya. Kenya now under the tutelage of Damien McGrath ahead of this tournament. Japan left to right now in their dark blue shirts. Can't win the ball at the restart because Herman Schiltz is the boss at restart time. And here's another authoritative figure, Gonzalez, with the carry. Here's Schiltz again. He's got Revol with him. Cuts him out. Tobias Wade picks the ball up. No Bazan Velez in this squad for Argentina. So plenty of minutes for Tobias Wade. Going to the floor is Joachim Della Vega, and this time it is Japan that get the penalty.
There's definitely been a conversation around this with the referees that they're certainly suggesting that the balance has to be there, that the fight over the ball, the contest, rather than almost a flying tackle that gets the player beyond the breakdown. It can be quite difficult to officiate at times, of which no doubt there'll be conversations around the game, but at least they've been consistent, which is really what you want to see. Tackle fine, and then clearing attacker has to seem to be balanced rather than making a hit beyond the contact. But that's a difficult one again when you're flying forward to try and keep your feet.
11.
So Japan 17-5 down, 5:50 to go in this second half. They've been offloading, tackle completion not great, but they've got the ball in hand here. Ryota Kano overthrows it straight into the hands of Della Vega. And he thunders upfield for Argentina. Here they come again. And here's Marcos Moneta, the chip and chase straight away with his first touch in Toulouse. And the World Sevens Player of the Year is already on the score sheet here.
Well, if that move wasn't already trademarked previously by his coach, Santi Gomez-Cora, this would be known as the Moneta. He puts it on the foot. Horrible drop, but manages to adjust it to get it where he needed to be on his foot and gets that fortuitous bounce, waiting, assessing, preparing for it. And all he's got to do is put it down. This man is a wonderful sight to behold on a sevens pitch.
Marcos Moneta. This marvellous young player for Argentina. 10 tries at the Vancouver event. They went all the way to the gold medal there. Conversion successful as well. So Argentina up to 24. Still just 22 years of age. Player of the year. Scores tries for fun. Handsome with it.
Almost one try a match. He has got some incredible statistics and so humble. It makes you not like the guy. He's got it all.
Speaks better English than us. There's Marcos Moneta, multilingual. Revol, the veteran, gets us back underway after the star rookie has scored. Gonzalez. Pressure, that's Della Vega over here on the near side. And here's Rodrigo Iscro, who's replaced. Gonzalez out there, and look at Iscro go. Nice angled run, dishes to Moneta, and Moneta has a double inside a minute of coming on.
Must be such a wonderful feeling to know at any point when you bring him in, he can have impact. But saying that, he'll be the first one to concede. He needs to be put in the right places. Isgro with a winding run, knows where the support's coming from, gets in between the defenders and puts it quite literally on a plate.
He was the star of the Olympics as well. 10 tries at that event. Brilliant in knocking out Team GB. They went all the way to the bronze medal in Tokyo, of course. It's really interesting how Santi Gomez-Cora uses him. Doesn't always start him, brings him on. Pivotal moments in games and never fails to impress.
It's a wonderful way of doing it. Keep him fresh, keep him excited, and get this crowd waving those flags even harder.
The tricolours are beginning to wave, and that's why France-Wales coming right up in Pool B.
It's okay. Good. Okay.
They love their rugby down here in Toulouse. Of course, home of the five-time European champions.
Rouge et Noir.
Yeah, this place goes off on top 14 days. European Champions Cup days as well. And it's about to go off for the first time with France playing on home soil with the men in the World Rugby Sevens event. Getting back here for Japan is Yoshihiro Noguchi. 29-5. Looking at two ends of the spectrum in terms of the standings on the series at the moment. Argentina.
Hey, double move, I'm holding on. I can see it.
In touching distance on the standings with South Africa after that win in Vancouver. They've medaled at five events on the series so far. Flung over the top here to De La Vega and Soejima. They hit the ruck hard, do Los Pumas Sevens. And here's Herman Schill to be lovely. If he could score a try, nice offload over the shoulder. Iskro can't take that, and Japan hack it away. Matias Osadzuk, who's back in this Argentina Sevens team. He's been away for a couple of years. And Lamas has the score for Argentina.
So many threats in this Argentinian squad, yet alone team. The ball was kicked downfield, perhaps speculatively, but then once it's opened up, so much time poised. A little bit of a dummy outside line. Beats the outside defenders and cruising on all cylinders.
They are one of the teams to beat here in Toulouse this weekend, no doubt about it. Argentina. They skip a beat no matter who comes on. And Osadzic and Lamas in combination there, and it'll be Lamas who will convert his own try. Still 1:30 to go here. Remember, if there are three teams equal on points at the end of the three rounds of pool play in a pool, it does come down to points difference. So Argentina want to keep racking them up here. Joaquin Lamas gets us restarted. Here is Asadzo. Offloads off the deck for Moneta, looking for his hat trick. He chips ahead, waiting for the ball to sit up. A bit more football and into the hands. Marcos Moneta, the money man for Argentina, has another hat trick.
That one was ridiculous. Very few people would have even considered the second touch, but the first one's exquisite. He knows what he's going to do, gets the ball exactly the right drop, puts it on the right foot over the top, and then it's just pace, leaving everyone for dead. A representation of normal human speed is the touchage on the side, and he's nowhere near that secondary one. That's special.
Well, in a country that loves its football, he showed some great skills there, Marcos Moneta. There you go, five medals this season, the most of any team. That's why they're in contention for the title. They really have reeled in South Africa at the top of the standings. Makisi off the bench, put on the floor by Agustin Fraga. Fox in the red, final play. So Ojima just gets the offload away in time. Schultz puts the pressure on. Japan make the error. And Argentina, a very impressive beginning for the second seeds here at the HSBC France Sevens. They've started with a big